Ben and I are on our way to go pick up our puppy, our Tux, our very first dog together.
Let's go get him.
I'm here with Tux today. We are here to tell you everything that you need to know about having a Dalmatian.
Oh, hi, buddy.
Tux is now 5 and a half, almost 6 months. He is about 15 kilograms. I think that's about 32 pounds. You are the most perfect thing in the whole world. He is such a baby. What are you gonna say?
Say hi.
Hi. He's like, I really don't think I wanna come up there.
Are you being shy? Okay, that's okay.
What's up, everybody? My name is Madison. I typically post lifestyle, travel, living abroad vlogs, but today I have a very important topic to talk about, and that is what you need to know about getting a Dalmatian. You have probably clicked on this video because you are thinking about getting a Dalmatian, or just got a Dalmatian, or just maybe want to learn more about Dalmatians. Anyway, you're here, so let's talk about it. Here are all the things that you need to know about getting a Dalmatian puppy. This features Tux and some of the experiences we went through. I wanted to film this a long time ago. He's clearly already 5 and a half months, almost six, but you know, he was a puppy, and we're gonna get into why it was probably challenging to film when he was a little puppy, but now is a good time because he's calm.
Hi.
Oh my gosh, he is just the cutest, sweetest thing in the whole world. Okay, I'll let you down, buddy, so we can talk. Here are the things that no one tells you about getting a Dalmatian. Let's start off by their temperament, their busyness, their energy. When you read about Dalmatians, you read that they are very energetic, and I would say you could take that to the maximum. Tux is chewing at my chair right now. Having a Dalmatian means your dog will be energetic literally 24/7. My twin sister has a Corgi, and the Corgi is really energetic at times, loves to run around, loves to be chased. But nothing compared to having a Dalmatian. This dog will go run around all day and all night. He just started to finally calm down, take nap times, like to chill on the couch. But just need to know that your dog is energetic a lot more in the beginning. They definitely need to be occupied most of the day. When Tux was a puppy, I could barely even work without having to entertain him in some ways. So I would say, like, just about when we hit like the 4 month mark, he started to become a little bit more chill and was able to, I always call it independent play. Like, he could play on his own, play with his toys without me having to like play with him or run around with him. I would say the best thing that you can do for your Dalmatian is play fetch. Throw a tennis ball, like, you literally can be stationary. You don't really have to do anything, but your dog gets an amazing workout and they can run for miles and miles. So taking them on a walk is a great idea, but they're not gonna be super tired after their walk. So definitely playing fetch is a good way that I release Tux's energy when he's a little puppy. Learn some commands, come here with treats. I'm just gonna roll right into the next one now that I said treats. Dalmatians are very stubborn, okay? So like, I feel like my dog mirrors my energy, but he is very, very stubborn when it comes to training. He definitely learns basic things, but we are still 5 months in working on some pretty basic commands because Tux is stubborn. He's a good dog, but takes him a while to learn, and he will outsmart you. And sometimes, like, I found myself in situations where I was rewarding Tux for doing the right thing, but then he would do the bad thing just to do the good thing again. I was like, dang, you are so smart. Like, he would jump on the couch just to jump off because he knew he wasn't allowed on the couch, and he'd get a treat if he got off. So stick with the training. It will eventually work. Just take some time. You gotta be patient with your Dalmatian. Seriously, it's all about patience and understanding and not letting them like outsmart you. You need to just be the one in the situation to, you know, you own your dog. You guys are a partnership, but you need to be strong and tell them no. I would say a very, very good thing to do right off the bat, I know this is kind of controversial, but definitely crate train. I really don't know where we would be in this journey with Tux without crate training. He loves his crate, loves it. He goes into it to chill, have a long time, and it's like, I'm done playing with you guys. You're boring me, this is enough. So he likes to go into his crate and just chill. His toys are in there. It's like a little oasis. He's got his bed. He likes it. Right away, he did. I will say, I've heard so many people say I gave up on crate training right away because it was really hard. Yeah, it is hard. It is super, super hard. And nobody likes to just leave their dog alone. But it's really, really important to, you know, establish the boundaries, give them their own space to hang out. Like, that is Tux's own little sanctuary. We don't get to go in it. That is for him only. So just give him that little, like, piece of independence. Right away, he would cry, he would bark, but we had to get through it. What we did was, after he would get done with his huge barking fit, his huge crying fit, he'd be silent. Then we'd go over, give him a treat, good boy, and then let him out. So he knows that once he's calm and collected and behaves correctly, we will let him out. And then he just started getting used to it. He was like, this isn't so bad. It is hard right away. Don't give up just because they're barking and feel uncomfortable. Stick with it. I promise it is 100% worth it in the long run. The next thing I want to talk about is a Dalmatian's diet. We really stick to the low purine. We give Tux turkey and sweet potato, very lean diets, low in like that super red meat protein. We've also seen Dalmatians that are very overweight or are fed incorrectly, and that is just not right for them. Don't get me wrong, I love like a big chubby fat dog. I think they're super cute, but Dalmatians are not meant to be fat and chubby. And if that is the kind of breed that you're looking for, I would suggest getting a different dog. They are really lean in their body type. Their diets are really important. So definitely look into it and see if that fits into your lifestyle, if that fits into your budget needs, because it's super important to make sure that they are eating the correct food. I've always read that Dalmatians shed a ton, and they do. Tux sheds a lot. It's small, like little white hairs that are a little bit more coarse, but it's really not that bad. I always have read everything that was like, shedding is everywhere. Yeah, they shed, they're a dog, but it's not the worst shedding I've ever seen, and it's really not that bad. They're super low maintenance when it comes to grooming. We've had Tux for almost 6 months and we've never had to give him a haircut. Don't come after me if that's incorrect. Let me know if that's incorrect. They kind of self groom, so that's a really nice thing about having a Dalmatian. Their shedding really isn't that bad. Don't let people scare you. You're not getting a Dalmatian because of shedding. Okay, so I already told you about their energy, their strict diets, you know, crate training, that they're stubborn. But here are the things that no one tells you about a Dalmatian. They are the most loyal, loving dogs ever. I am obsessed with Tux. He is seriously my best friend. He's the sweetest thing in the world. He is very protective, very loyal, and through the stubbornness, he's seriously the cutest thing in the entire world. He has his spunky, energetic times, but he also loves to chill. And it makes me sad. Like, one time Tux was sick and he wasn't his normal spunky, energetic self, and I missed it. I was sad. So yeah, they are energetic, but you just have to have like the right routine to allow their energy to be released. You know, like I said, fetch, long walks, and you'll be fine, honestly. And one last thing I want to mention, you know, Dalmatians are a lot of work. Along with any puppy is going to be a ton of work. I think back to the potty training stage, and it was so hard. I seriously thought to myself, I'm never going to have my normal life back. We were taking Tux out every 2 hours, and at that point, we were living in an apartment on the fourth floor. So we were bringing him out every 2 hours, seriously, like midnight, 2 a.m., 4 a.m., 6 a.m., 8 a.m. I was so tired and barely had enough energy to play with him. But you will get through it. It is so important to do those small increments of potty training. Teach him right away that you cannot, you know, go potty in the house. This is where you go outside. And the point is to catch him before they go to the bathroom, so that they know that's where I have to go and I can't go at my crates. But just know that you will get through it. It is so challenging in the beginning. I seriously thought to myself, oh my God, I'll never have my normal life back. You will, and your life will actually be enhanced with your puppy. He seriously has brought so much joy and like purpose to my life. I know it sounds so cheesy and you might laugh at me for saying that, but seriously, my dog gives me so much joy. And my new routine is so great with him, and it is really hard right away. Don't give up. Don't be super scared when you kind of are nervous, like, did I make the right decision getting a puppy? You did if you did enough research and it's right with your routine. It is okay. Things will get better. It is really stressful in the beginning. I am so glad we made it through those really tough stages. Take lots of pictures, lots of videos when they're young, because they grow up so fast. Tux used to be like, I used to really like hold him like this, and now he's so heavy, I get an actual ab workout and strong biceps when I pick him up. But those are the things that no one tells you about a Dalmatian. You need to cherish the memories of him when he's a rambunctious little puppy, because they grow up insanely fast. Tux and I say thank you so much for watching. If you like videos like this, like, comment, subscribe, all the things. We will see you in the next video. Bye!